Welcome to This Week in the Index. I am your host, Grayson Brulte. Overall, it was a good week in the markets for the week of July 10th. The Road to Autonomy Index returned 3.43%. The S&P 500 returned 2.27%. The NASDAQ 100 returned 3.96%. The Road to Autonomy Index outperformed the S&P 500 by 1.16%. The Road to Autonomy Index underperformed the NASDAQ 100 by 0.53%. The top performing stocks in the Road to Autonomy Index this week were Goodyear, which returned 10.46%, Glencore, which returned 6.98%, NVIDIA, which returned 6.98%. While these stocks perform well, they are just three of the 38 publicly traded companies that are components of the Road to Autonomy Index. News and opinion drives the market, and this week in autonomy, there were some developments. During Daimler Truck Holdings Capital Market Day 2023 in Boston, the company announced that it expects revenues to grow as much as 60% between 2025 and 2030. Furthermore, the company announced that autonomy is now a strategic pillar for the company. As they work to establish an ecosystem with recurring revenue from autonomy with a dual-track strategy. Daimler Truck's dual-track strategy involves a captive solution and a non-captive solution to autonomous trucking. The captive solution will be powered by Torc, which is led by Peter von Schmidt. It will be a fully integrated, pure-play trucking product optimized for hub-to-hub development and deployed with customer feedback in mind. The non-captive solution will involve selling redundant autonomous-ready chassis to partners, including Waymo. Waymo's parent company, Alphabet, is a Road to Autonomy Index component. This dual approach will allow Daimler Truck to gain market share and capture sustainable long-term revenue. Starting in 2027, Daimler Truck will begin delivering factory-grade autonomous trucks to the market. By 2030, the company is projecting 3 billion euro in potential revenue, with 1 billion euro in earnings before interest and taxes. If these projections hold true, Daimler Truck is laying the foundation for a big business, a very big business, a business that is investable. On the news, the stock rallied 2.5%. When the Daimler autonomous trucks powered by Torc begin to come to the market in 2027, they will operate in a hub-to-hub model in the southwest of the United States, where Torc is currently testing in Albuquerque, New Mexico. The first mile of the journey will be human-driven, along with the last mile. This approach to autonomous trucking will allow Daimler to scale quickly. It's a similar approach that Kodiak Robotics is taking, along with several other of the autonomous trucking startups. In order for the hub-to-hub model to scale across the country, there has to be infrastructure investments made. The depots of today will have to be updated, retrofitted to accommodate autonomous trucks. This creates an opportunity for Prologis, a Road to Autonomy Index component company, CBRE, and Blackstone, as they all have very large exposure to commercial real estate. Prologis currently owns over 1.2 billion square feet of logistics real estate across 19 countries, while Blackstone is the largest owner of commercial real estate globally, owning and operating assets across every major geography and sector, including logistics, residential, office, hospitality, and retail. Infrastructure will play a key role in the future of autonomy, and both Prologis and Blackstone are well positioned to benefit as the logistics industry shifts to autonomous trucking. For Blackstone, they will also benefit from autonomous vehicles as they scale around the world, as these vehicles will need urban depots to be charged, cleaned, and maintained. Without the proper infrastructure, autonomy does not scale. Even if autonomous vehicles and autonomous trucks have the world's greatest infrastructure, they still need public trust. In California, we're seeing an aggressive effort to derail an industry that will create millions and millions of new jobs and usher in the autonomy economy. In Los Angeles, Fran Drescher, we all know her as a role in The Nanny. She's now president of SAG-AFTRA. Stated the following in an interview with The Hollywood Reporter on Thursday, July 13th about the SAG-AFTRA strike, and I quote, "I think the whole world is looking at us right now because human beings in all different walks of life are being replaced by robots. And what happens here? The eyes of the world and certainly labor in this country is looking at it. It's really important that we put barricades around artificial intelligence because it's going to put people out of work." End quote. This could not be farther from the truth, as we can use history as a guide. when ATMs were first commercialized, there was outrage that they were going to kill bank teller jobs. Guess what happened? The exact opposite happened. It actually created jobs, didn't kill jobs. In 1985, the United States had 60,000 ATMs and 485,000 bank tellers. By 2002, the number of ATMs increased to 352,000. And the number of bank tellers, well, it increased to 527,000. There was no job loss, only job increases. Factoring in the jobs that were created to build and service the ATMs, you add thousands of more jobs into the equation. ATMs turn out to be good for the banking industry, the economy, and society as a whole. Despite all the negative backlash around automation and autonomy, 75% of the global public trust the technology sector, a 1-point increase year over year, according to the 2023 Edelman Trust Barometer. Even with a strong majority of the public trust in the technology sector, there are individuals out there who are doing their best to sabotage the autonomous vehicle industry. What truly motivates these individuals? We don't know. What we do know and what we can verify is that there's a coordinated effort to derail this industry in California. In San Francisco, individuals are running around the city stealing cones and placing them on autonomous vehicles to disable them and then posting the outcome to social media. Little do these individuals realize that the autonomous vehicles are capturing all their antics and vandalization of private property on camera. At some point, these individuals will be arrested and charged for their crimes. But this will not stop the deep anger that these individuals have towards autonomous vehicles. It will only increase as they rage against the machine known as autonomy. The anger and rage being shown towards autonomous vehicles is also being unfortunately shown towards autonomous trucks, but in a different manner. Instead of putting cones on vehicles, the Teamsters Union in California is using their political might to permanently require that a truck has a driver in it at all times for a truck weighing over 10,000 pounds, even if the truck's autonomous. What the Teamsters do not realize is that they are killing jobs. Once again, let's look at history as our guide. In 1945, roughly 15,000 elevator operators, doormen, porters, and maintenance workers went on strike in New York City over the introduction of automated elevators, or commonly known back then as operator-less elevators. The strike cost an estimated $100 million in economic loss to the city of New York. In 1950, Otis Elevator installed a completely automated elevator in the Atlantic Refining Building in Dallas, Texas. That moment in 1950 ushered in the future of elevators, fully automated, with no elevator operator. That strike paved the way to ending an entire industry, elevator operators. Then it killed jobs. Today, elevators without operators is common. When you happen to find yourself in an elevator with an operator, you tend to find it odd. Striking did not work, and it will not work now. America was built on progress, and she will keep progressing and ushering in new technologies. It's time for society to come together and work together to create high-paying jobs instead of merely striking and using political tactics to try and ban a technology or render it unusable through bad acts. By requiring a driver in autonomous trucks at all time in California, say goodbye to jobs. You just killed them, not created them. History will always repeat itself in one form, fashion, or another. In the end, the rage will pass, but it will take time. To help it pass, the autonomous vehicle and truck industries need to come together and usher in a world-class PR campaign built around public trust. The industry has to highlight the benefits of autonomous vehicles and trucks in a way that clearly demonstrates how the technology will impact our lives. Collectively, as an industry, we have to come together to tell the story of autonomy. Imagine riding in an autonomous vehicle. What could it mean to you? What could you be doing in that vehicle? You could watch a movie, play a game, or interact with your friends, all without having to watch the road or pay attention to where you're going. Imagine arriving at your destination relaxed and not tired. This is all possible with autonomy. Autonomy is coming. Autonomous vehicles and autonomous trucks will help to usher in the autonomy economy. Today, we are merely at a starting point for what is to come with autonomy and the eventual positive economic impact it will have. In the future, autonomy will be one of the largest industries in the world. Autonomy is a business, and there is an index to track its performance. The autonomy economy is coming. Follow the Road to Autonomy Index, ticker Autonomy on your favorite finance app. Again, the ticker is Autonomy, A-U-T-O-N-O-M-Y. Be sure to join us again next week for the latest installment of the Road to Autonomy's This Week in the Index. The future is bright, the future's autonomous, and the future is a bright and vibrant autonomous vehicle industry.